Oh, why, hello there. I'm Jake. I am sitting in Michael's lovely floral chair that he sat in for 3 hours for the Prime Numbers video, and boy, it really formed to his body, and it...
It still...
Still has his musk. It's lovely. May I ask you a favor? Thank you. Here's two photos of me. Can you spot the difference? .com. That game is a lot more difficult because those pictures of me that you just saw are in two completely different locations. I'm not wearing the same outfit, and also one of them isn't me. But spotthedifference.com is a dong. Something that you can do online now, guys. On stargazing, you're given a map pinned with the best places to see the night sky. Each of these red stars has been designated as a good place to do so, and clicking on one gives you the information you need to check it out. Some are observatories, while others are just places where stars are more visible, like Hatteras Island. If Hatteras Island is too far away, just stargaze with Online Planetarium, where you can choose a location to view constellations from. Granted, they aren't real photographs of stars, but the benefit is you get to adjust factors to your liking. This includes time, date, and something called limiting magnitude. For the naked eye, this refers to the faintest stars that can be seen without the use of tools like telescopes or cameras. Now, there are 88 official constellations, and the brightest ones are in the northern hemisphere. The ones in the southern hemisphere are difficult to see just with the naked eye. Each constellation has an alpha star, which is the brightest out of all the ones that make it up. For example, Delta Capricorni is the alpha star of Capricornus, with an apparent magnitude of 3.58. There are factors that impair our ability to see the stars, like higher humidity and lower altitudes, but the biggest factor of all is light pollution. And to learn more about light pollution, head to globeatnight.org. The dots are color-coded based on limiting magnitude. The higher it is, the more light pollution there is, and consequently, less visibility. To understand how light pollution can affect our ability to see, here's a nifty little infographic. Obviously, some light is necessary, and that's this zone here, but when it goes beyond what it's supposed to light up, it ultimately brightens the sky. It not only harms this guy's freaking eyeballs, but it can affect other animals, especially if they're nocturnal. While predators use light to hunt species, their prey use darkness to cover up. Light pollution also causes something called sky glow. When the light on Earth reflects into the sky, some of it escapes into space, but the rest is scattered by molecules in the atmosphere. This makes it more difficult to see the stars. This is a beautiful scrolling experience, and you'll learn sky glow facts along the way. You can also interact with this map by scrolling from 1992 to 2025. The site will tell you the brightness by area in the year 2014. A lumen is a measure of the total quantity of visible light emitted by a source. Now, sky glow is thought to have a negative impact on people's health by contributing to certain sleep disorders. This can be because light can affect our melatonin levels, which are responsible for when we sleep and when we wake up, and then lack of sleep can be responsible for things like insomnia, depression, cardiovascular disease, and more. And it's hard to imagine a world without light pollution, but there is a simulator just for that. Light pollution is measured on the Bortle scale, which goes from 1 to 9. Sliding it all the way to the left shows you the darkest skies. Inner cities often measure a 9, and it makes stargazing much more difficult. Of course, this is a very simplistic simulation to demonstrate the effect of light pollution. If you want to see what your home measures on the Bortle scale, there are maps for just that. This page gives you the key, and then select from the maps down here. In North America, there's quite a bit of light pollution, but not many areas where it's a 9 on the scale. Now let's go from light pollution to Virtual Lighting Studio. This is a really great website for photographers or filmmakers, and I actually really appreciate it. You can choose among different kinds of lighting equipment to plan for a real life shoot. Check out this handsome fella. Click here to select the type of light you want to use, like a ring light. And ring lights are used by a lot of YouTube creators. It brightens the eyes while emitting soft enough light to decrease shadows. And it's fun to play around with the position of the lighting as well. Well, it's fun until you get this. You can adjust the intensity of the light, you can add different colored gels to it if you want to change the color temperature, and you can even add multiple lights to your lighting setup and adjust their positions to get the look that you want. Once you get the right lighting, let's move from photographs to paintings. Google Arts and Culture Experiments have collected a plethora of art pieces from museums and archives around the world. Art Palette analyzed thousands of pieces and calculated their color palettes. This site is very cool because you can find art pieces by adjusting 5 different colors to your liking. It's curious to see what you can get because sometimes what would seem like a garish color combination actually creates some awesome art. If you want to see what pieces share a color scheme with something you created or photographed, you can do that right here. And that's enough visual art, so let's go to audio art with Rave DJ, where you can mash up any 2 YouTube videos you like. Let's try M83's Midnight City and the Barney theme song.
I
Oh, yeah, that's great. What a work of art. And if for some reason people don't like the music that you make, well, just take it away with you to an island you created on Draw Your Island. First, draw yourself. Wow, that looks exactly like me. Now I'm gonna draw my best friend, aka Michael Stevens, a campfire, some smoke, a pet taco, and a fish, I guess. The list goes on, but look at my island. Yay! If you enjoyed these dongs and you want to keep learning about the night sky, then I would highly recommend checking out the astronomy course on brilliant.org, who is nice enough to sponsor this video. And Brilliant lines up really beautifully with what we're trying to do here at Vsauce. They offer courses in science, math, problem solving, and astronomy. So one such course is the life cycle of stars. It goes through star formation, stellar evolution, and black holes. If you want to check out Brilliant, the first 36 people to click that link at the top of the description get 20% off a premium annual subscription, and they are lovely human beings over at Brilliant, and I am really appreciative of them supporting Vsauce. And also this chair. I get why Michael really likes this chair. It's very comfortable. You kind of just sink in a little bit. I scooched, you know? It's very nice. Also, fun fact about that prime number video. Michael actually did it for 6 hours. We filmed it once. There was a problem. So then Michael and I came in on Saturday and filmed it again. So that is really good on you, Michael. I'm very proud of you. And if you want to tell Michael how proud you are, you can go follow his personal Twitter that not many people, I don't think, really know about. It's at I'm not Michael Stevens. Jake, please don't ever put this in a video. That would be terrible. That's his handle. Go let him know that you really love him and appreciate all the dongs that he brings into this world. And I'm gonna go take off this sweater and beanie because I miscalculated how hot it would be today, especially in this hot studio with all these hot lights. I'm gonna stop speaking, and as always, thanks for watching. Oh, that's the ticket. That's the ticket. The seat fell out. This is good, but I gotta keep going, Jack. Oh, no. The cushion, Jack, the cushion stuck in my butt. Jack, you gotta get the cushion out of my butt.
Nope.
Jack!
Nope.
Jack! The cushion! Oh, it hurts. I can't move anymore. Okay, we can cut. I think we can cut now.